Hi, this is Your Voice. I'm Julia Locandy. Today, Senate Finance Chairman John DeFrancisco is here to talk about some young kids in his district that he's acknowledged and bragged about to his colleagues. How are you, Senator?
I'm doing well, thank you.
You have bragging rights.
We have a lot of great people in Central New York and doing great things, especially the young people, and we try to recognize.
Yeah, you know, many school groups get to come to Albany. They get to watch your debates, go to the State Museum, tour the Capitol, and they get to talk to you as well.
Yeah, it's a great thing. I've been doing it for the 20 years I've been in the Senate, and I enjoy it. I give the students the opportunity to ask me questions directly. They see Senate session for a while, and they do all the things that you just mentioned. So I think it's a great learning experience, and we'll continue to do it as long as I'm here.
Yes, recently some kids from Roberts Elementary School just came and did just that.
Yes, there's usually at least a group a week, especially towards the end of school year, and we talk to them, and there I'm explaining something. But I know the one thing I always talk to every single school group that have come for 20 years, and that is the importance of reading. And I explain how important it was to me, how important it is to them, and if they really want to be successful, that's what they should be doing. And I usually tell the kids, if they see me in Syracuse, come up to me and tell me what they're reading. And kids do, you know, so it's kind of encouraging. It's a lot of fun, and I think they enjoy the trip.
So throughout this year on Your Voice, we've been talking about some people that you've been pointing out in session, honoring and giving resolutions. They've stood out, whether it be academics or athletics or just contributions that they've made to society. And recently you recognized one young man who has done all of that, Christopher Collins. He's a world karate champ, studies biology at Lemoyne College, volunteers his time for his community. Let's go to a clip of you explaining his outstanding achievement.
He's truly a remarkable young man. He actually won the 2011 World Karate Championships. World, I said. You hear that? World. World. At age 17. At age 17. He's a native of Syracuse. Started studying karate at the age of 8, mastering tips from both his father, Terrence Collins, a 6th-degree black belt. So that don't monkey around with Mr. Collins. And Carlos Tierney, a martial arts champion and instructor in Syracuse. Christopher Collins grew to be a fierce competitor in karate, winning numerous local competitions before entering the Northeast Regional Competition in April of 2011. He obviously won that and on his way to the World Championships. Along with four other athletes, the U.S. Karate Team at the World Kickboxing Council, World Karate Championships, et cetera, from October 31 to November 4th. Christopher Collins defeated three other competitors during the finals, placing first and earning a gold medal in the traditional forms division. Besides becoming a world karate champion at the young age of 17, Christopher Collins is also a dedicated community volunteer and a biology major at Lemoyne College now. So we stand to commend Christopher and his father for his obviously wonderful guidance. And we've been honoring people, young people, all year long. And I think one of the most important things about these great young champions is they're excellent students as well. They're also community volunteers. There's a common thread there. They're responsible, hardworking young people that will be our leaders tomorrow. So I want to congratulate Christopher and his father, and note that this particular resolution has been previously unanimously adopted by this body. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator DeFrancisco. We want to congratulate Christopher and welcome him and his dad here to the chamber today. Congratulations.
Looks like he has a really good role model.
I'm glad you mentioned that. I'll tell you, I talked to the father. What a gentleman. What a solid, solid citizen. And he was so appreciative of being there for his son and so proud of his son. And his son, you know, Chris, was just a great young man. I mean, and the problem is in the news media, you hear all the bad things that the young people are doing. But every time you get a young man like that, and his father guiding him in the chambers, you realize there is some hope for the society, and just they're terrific, and it was a real pleasure to have them there.
Yeah, now let's acknowledge a girls basketball team in Syracuse, champions, who won two consecutive state championships, also kept up their grades. Let's take a listen to what you have to say about them.
I'm very proud and honored to rise to congratulate the Cicero North Syracuse girls basketball team and coach Eric Smith, assistant coaches Laura Schilly and Bill Aldrich, who are here with us today for winning two consecutive state championships. These are truly outstanding young athletes. And before I talk a little bit about their athletic prowess, as a scholar athlete team, they had a combined 92 grade point average, which is quite an accomplishment in view of all the practices, all the games, all the dedication that they had to put into this incredible winning combination. They won the championship game this year 62-48, so it wasn't even close. They went on to win the Federation Championship as well, and they also went on a national championship tournament in Phoenix, Arizona, known as the most competitive tournament in the country, where they were semifinalists. And in the course of the season, they beat three top 25 nationally ranked teams. It is absolutely unbelievable what they have done.
Some good stuff.
It really is good stuff, and they were great young ladies. We had a good time with them. We normally, in a situation like that, they came to lunch. We had pizzas and sodas and all good, nutritious food for them when they came in. But they had a good time, and they're truly a remarkable young group of people.
Right, and one of the players on the team received a special resolution for her standout accomplishments. Let's take a look at what you had to say about Breanna Stewart's phenomenal record of achievement.
Is the best female basketball player in the entire country. And since she's the best, she's going to be going to University of Connecticut next year and lead the University of Connecticut to another national championship in their long history of national championships. She not only was named this year's Player of the Year by Gatorade, but listen to this, information about her. She's a 6'4 forward, and by the way, I played basketball at the Syracuse YMCA with her father. He's about a head shorter, and I'm about a head shorter than him. But she not only started playing basketball, playing for the team as an eighth grader, she continued on after that time, and during this season, she led the team to a 23-3 record, and I told you about the other accomplishments of the team. She was selected to the USA Basketball Women's Under-16 National Team at the age of 14. She was the leading scorer and rebounder for the USA Basketball Women's Under-19 National Team that won the 2011 World Championships. She participated in the McDonald's All-American Game. And she has a school career number of points. Listen to this, 2,367. She was named the Morgan Wooden Player of the Year and the USA Basketball's Female Athlete of the Year, and it goes on. And she's just a wonderful young woman as well. I've met her on a prior occasion. And so with that said, I proudly move this resolution.
You know, she She's a fine young lady, but can you imagine the top player in the country, also from Central New York, Cicero mm-hmm. North Syracuse? You know, just an amazing situation, and she's very humble young woman, and she's terrific. She's going to go to University of Connecticut, one of the best basketball teams for women in for the last 20 years, or at least 10 years. So it's exciting for us to be part of her great accomplishments.
Yeah, an exciting life she has ahead of her.
No question about it.
So Hall of Fame football player Floyd Little was recognized in the chamber recently. You know him and his wife, right?
I do. Deborah used to be a city councilor, and I've known her for many, many years. And I've known of Floyd. I don't know him as well as his wife because of her political activities. But a great man, great athlete. Right.
While he was being honored for his success, you got up to say a few words and make everyone laugh.
Well,
of course.
Every so often.
Let's take a look.
Floyd Little probably was one of the greatest football players, not probably, was one of the greatest football players ever to play the game, whether high school, college, or professional. But more than that, he's an incredible citizen, and he's always maintained his loyalty to the city of Syracuse. And he's here with his wife, Deborah, who I've known for many, many years, a wonderful, wonderful woman, and they each married great people, and it's a wonderful partnership. Also, Floyd, you don't know this, but just about every day I am honoring some great athletes and great people, because Central New York is where all the outstanding athletes come from. And I want you to know that I want the chamber to know I didn't bring Floyd here. It's others did, and so it's not even me recognizing this. The only thing that I have against Floyd is that when he was doing great things on the football field, I was playing baseball for Syracuse, and the only thing I could say bad about him, he didn't have enough guts to play baseball. But. No, in all seriousness, this is a great day. Floyd's a great person, great human being, great athlete, and it's wonderful to invite him, to have him here in our chambers. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
You know, we've honored a lot of Central New Yorkers and teams and so forth. I always have that same shtick about how all the great athletes are from Central New York, and it's not too far off. I mean, we've honored more people for great athletic achievements, great academic achievements, and I'm really proud to represent Central New York. But the funny thing is that this was on a Thursday, I believe, and on Saturday night there was a party that I attended with my wife, and Floyd and his wife coincidentally were at the same party. And as he was approaching me, I had to explain quickly. I said, "Floyd, I really didn't mean it, that you didn't have the guts." Because he's a pretty intimidating guy, but a wonderful guy. His wife's a great woman, and so we do a lot of important legislation. We work hard at what we're doing, but there's also this part of the job that's really important. If you don't recognize the people doing the right things, then you're not doing your job completely, because you have to encourage people to do well, and that's what we try to do in addition to the legislation that we work on.
Right, it's good to have people to look up to, good role models like yourself, and even kids who can actually look up to other kids, their peers, and you know, feel
There's
good
no
about
question.
That.
And the pictures at the beginning of the program of the young kids, I'm telling them to read. Two people that work for me now in my Senate office got their pictures of when they came to Albany, and maybe they listened.
Yeah. See what it could do. Thanks so much for being with us, Senator.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching Your Voice with Senator John DeFrancisco. For any additional information, defrancisco.nysenate.gov.